Hey, so how's it going? I am awesome myself because I am about to show you a very cool historic house downtown Orangeville. It is 78 feet of frontage and 120 feet deep, so it's a nice large lot. Walk down to the farmer's market for the summer. You can go to all the restaurants and shops. They're great places in the downtown. You know, we have all those like cool festivals and stuff in the summer, right? So here it is, 17 Amanda Street. So recently I took an architecture course, just kind of like vintage architectures of Ontario. I'll be definitely throwing around some cool architectural terms just to impress you. So this house is considered a Gothic revival architectural style. So let me show you a couple cool things about it. So you see where this brick is down on the front here. Now this is, it's very interesting that it's actually raised a little bit. And this is actually called coining. So there's a cool term for the day. Now at the side of the property, this is what's called the gable end. So this just means that the roof line you can see is on this side of the property. So the gable ends of the house are on the sides of the property. You'll notice this is the extra wide lot here and terrific little patio. So this is done like in a herringbone style brick pattern. And a great little spot to hang out here, and not to mention there is a lot more space even in the backyard. So the backyard has another little patio section here, and as you can see, it is fully fenced, and what a large area. So you see behind me, there's a great little garden in the far corner, and if I turn around, you get to see the house in the background, and look at all this lawn. I mean, this is amazing. So, I mean, imagine the game of croquet you could play. It would be awesome. So let's head inside, and we'll check out the interior. Right off the bat, you'll notice that there's this great little mudroom. So perfect spot for the coats, and actually you can store items out here, outdoor items, or you can even put like a little chair set here and enjoy it in the summer. Now, as you enter the house, you can't help but notice these gleaming, beautiful refinished floors. Now these are the original floors. They've just been refinished in a really high gloss shine. Now this living room faces the front of the house. Nice bright windows on either side. These windows have been replaced. So they are, I think, 2004. Keep cozy in the wintertime with this great little gas stove. No need for cutting any wood. Amazing big baseboards. And as you can see, just a great little sitting area. Coming back this way, you notice there's a nice little dining room right here. So you could have a larger table here if you wanted. And you could even hang like a chandelier here if you needed. So just a really nice open concept space. Now I'm going to take you through to the kitchen. Now this kitchen is in the other part of the house, so the older part. And as you can see, it's a little bit sunken, so I'm going down a couple stairs. There is a ton of room here. So you can see, this is a complete eat-in kitchen because there's this gigantic extra space right here. The kitchen features some undermount lighting here and so a nice tile backsplash. So coming off the kitchen is this great little sunroom. It's also the laundry room. So you'll see the laundry is right here. This comes with it, like I said. And a little view into the backyard. This room features some storage and also it's access to the unfinished basement. Let's go upstairs. This is three bedrooms upstairs here. So first off, I'll take you to the back bedroom, which is just through here. And this bedroom could be set up as the master. You see it's only a futon right now. So this could be rolled out to make a bedroom for like, a guest. And has a beautiful view to the back of the property. So here is the upper level bathroom. So you can see it's a four piece that has the tub shower combo here. And over this way we have the vanity, which has a great side light coming in from the side of the property. This bathroom also has some extra storage right here. So you can have pile up all your supplies right here. So here's what's being used as a master bedroom right now. So you can see it's spacious enough and it has the vaulted ceiling in here. And little closet off into the side here. The exposure is just down Amanda Street. The smallest bedroom is currently being used as an office, and this is the bedroom that's off the front of the property. So I realize it's just a very quick tour, but if you're interested in coming seeing this property in person, and I can show off all my the other cool historic architectural terms that I learned, please give me a call. My name is Ross Hughes. Call me at 519-938-2225. That's my cell phone. Or you can page me through my office. It's 519-941-5151. Hope you've enjoyed the tour, and I can't wait to show it to you in person, so give me a call. Thanks.